comes with a lot less hair, but the same voice and the same beautiful number of things. He does amazing. Thoroughly enjoyed that. He is a frequent guest here at Living Water Coffee House. As is Becky B and her puppetry. Come on up, Becky. Take a go away because we have a special treat for you, John Doyle, and his 100 quotes for yoke. He's going to share a couple of them with you when Becky has finished her beautiful poetry. Thank you for staying around and enjoying. My love, sent from above, a beautiful child of the precious dove, everlasting Father, a gift of hope. He increases my joy, his kisses of love, more and more each day. His name is old, before time began, he was. His peace quiet my restless soul, tenderly wiping all my tears away. Under his wings, I find the victory I need. He is Lord of all, I exalt his holy name. You are everything to me, Jesus, my Lord, amazing King. In ways we cannot see, in ways we may not know, in ways we feel his gentle spirit teaching us, guiding us, showing us his love, his grace. His life is our life. His joy becomes our joy. His peace becomes our peace. His light shines in our darkness. His tears become our salvation. Knowing him changes us. We become like him. We love you, Jesus, because you first loved us. This life, it's not about me. It's not about me. This life is all about God. Rising us up above ourselves, above our circumstances. It's about the Holy Spirit moving through us. It's about Jesus bringing us to his cross, his salvation, his death in our life. Your fame won't get you to heaven. Being poor won't get you to heaven. Your riches won't get you to the pearly gates. Is your name written in the Lamb's Book of Life? Want to find out, ask me at the end, I'll let you know. It's important to trust Jesus today and always, and this is why, because you are a child of promise. He wants you to be joyful. He wants you to be strong. He cares all about you. He loves you. He doesn't want you to be afraid. He wants you to be healthy. He wants you to love others. God is love. Love never fails. Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. My brother Hank died 3 years ago. He was 42. He was killed in a car accident. And for 4 months, I couldn't couldn't do a thing. I couldn't lift my head out of bed. I got out of bed to go eat and, you know, and slept for 4 months. And I just kept praying, and I really believe God's people were praying for me, my family, my loved ones, you know. And when people are in that situation, their grief and their despair is so bad. It's like sometimes people just need Jesus. They need to see the light. Sometimes you might be the only light that shines in their darkness. So remember, be the light. Jesus sent us to be the light to the world. Heaven's just a teardrop away. It was only yesterday that you went away. I didn't get to say goodbye. There was so much left to say. So much more life and laughter, tears and fears just washed away. I wish you were near. I know I'll see your sweet smiling face and feel your warm embrace when you and I meet, when we sit at Jesus' feet.
Thank you, Becky, for this wonderful testimony. John Doyle is coming up, and as he's coming up, I want Dwayne to share a testimony with you. Something that he shared with me, I just know that you'll be blessed by it. Dwayne?
I just want to say how good God is. It's only going to take a brief moment. Earlier this week, Tuesday. Yeah, it was on Tuesday. This is Casey. And she came by the house. And I tell you how good God is. She came by the house and had dinner. And, well, I actually just had a celebration with my son. My son's birthday was Wednesday. He had to work, so we celebrated, had cake and everything. And it was raining real bad. She's a new driver, a couple months. So she said, well, Dad, I'm leaving. And me and my wife, Pat, we said, okay, you take care and go on home. Be careful. Take your time. About 10 minutes later, got a phone call. She's hysterical. Dad, I was just in an accident. I said, you all right? Where you at? Right up the street from our house. Pouring down rain. We got to the scene of the accident. The vehicle was on its roof. Somehow she had managed without getting a scratch, without getting hurt, injured severely, with a vehicle that hit a pole, flipped over, in the middle of the street on a rainy night, nobody slammed the car. Nobody else. God is good. No broken bones. A little sore, but no cuts, nothing. And I gotta say, God is good.
God is good. I don't even know how I managed to get out of the car. Thank God that the driver's side window had smashed, because that was the only way out. The only way. And I thank God.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.